Students, welcome to Justin NCRT Solutions. In this video, we are going to see 7th Standard Maths Chapter 9 Rational Numbers Introduction Part. Here, rational numbers is come from the word ratio. We are going to see what is a rational number. First, a number can be expressed in the form of P by Q. A number can be expressed in the form of P by Q, where P and Q are integers and Q not equal to 0. If a number can be expressed in the form of P by Q, P and Q are integers and Q not equal to 0, that number is called as rational number. We will take two integers, 3 by 7. 3 and 7 are integers and here 7 not equal to 0. Therefore, 3 by 7 is a rational number. And you can ask that this is like fraction. Fraction and rational numbers are same, a small difference is there. Fraction only positive numbers will come. In rational number, we will write negative numbers also. Minus 2 by 7, opposite of 3 by 7. Minus 3 by 7. In fraction, we will have only positive numbers. In rational numbers, we will have negative numbers also. That is called rational numbers. Next, we are going to see that equivalent rational numbers. Now, equivalent rational number. We will take a rational number minus 5 by 8. Equivalent rational number, if a number is multiplied and divided by a same number, it will give another one rational number. For example, if you are multiplying divide by 2 by 2, 5 2s are 10, minus into plus equal to minus, divided by 8 2s are 16. So now minus 5 by 8 minus 10 by 16 are equivalent rational numbers. Because if you simplify this, you will get again the same number, minus 5 by 8. And now we can check it. 12 by 16, 12 by 18 and 24 by 36 are equivalent rational numbers. We will check it. If you have simplified this, we can simplify by 6. 2 6 are 12. 3 6 are 18. Next here, 2 12s are 24. 3 12s are 36. Now, 2 by 3 is equal to 2 by 3. When we are simplifying, this 12 by 18 and 24 by 36 are giving equal values. The ratio are equal. Therefore, this 12 by 18 and 24 by 36 are called equivalent rational numbers. So that's all. Next we will go for the next topic. That is rational numbers on a number line. Rational numbers on a number line. We will take a number 5 by 6 on a number line. You will take this is first a whole number. Minus 4. This is a number, this is number line for integers. We have to mark it for rational numbers. Here 5 by 6 don't have separate place. So here 5 by 6 is coming between 1, 0 and 1. We can check it here. 5 is not divisible by 6. Now we are adding 0 point. We are adding 0 here now. So 6 8s are 48. Remaining 2. And now this 0.8 is coming between 0 and 1. So that number is between 0 and 1. We are going to extend this number line. We are going to extend this number line 0 and 1 alone. We will take this is minus 1, this is 0, and the right hand side we are going to take it as a 1 by 6, 2 by 6, 3 by 6, 4 by 6, 5 by 6, 6 by 6, 7 by 6, 8 by 6, 9 by 6, like that we can write it as it is. Here left hand side minus 1 by 6 will come. Now we are going to mark this 5 by 6. Here 5 by 6 is coming here. 5 by 6 on the number line. And when 6 by 6 is coming, this will become 1. 1. So in between 0 and 1, we can make it unlimited numbers. You can take it for 1 by 100, 1 by crore, 1 by 1000, any number. That can come between 0 and 1. And this is the way to write the rational numbers on a number line. Next part. Standard form. We are going to take 12 by 15. The meaning of standard form, another name is simplest form also we can say it. Simplest form. The meaning of simplest form, we have to divide it by a common divisor up to the least level. So now we are going to simplify. 12 and 15 can be divisible by 3. 4 threes are 12, 5 threes are 15. Now 4 by 5. 4 and 5 having only one as a common divisor. We don't have any other common divisor. We cannot simplify. So this 4 by 5 is the simplest form of 12 by 15. Next, if we are taking number 30 divided by 40, we can divide it by 10. When we are dividing, 0, 0 cancel. Remaining 3 by 4. Hereafter, we cannot simplify this 3 by 4. So 3 by 4 is the simplest form of 30 by 40. And this is the meaning for standard form. Next one, rational numbers. Between two rational numbers. We are going to find rational numbers between two rational numbers. Here we are going to take a number 2 by 3 and 3 by 4. We are going to find three rational numbers between 2 by 3 and 3 by 4. Here denominators are different. So first we have to convert this denominator into common. So 2 by 3 into 4 by 4 is equal to 2 fours are 8, 3 fours are 12. Next we are going to convert this 3 by 4. 3 by 3 is equal to 3 threes are 9, 4 threes are 12. Now 8 by 12, 9 by 12, both also common denominator. Now I am going to convert this by 5 by 5 into 5 by 5. Both also I might be multiplying by 5 by 5. Is equal to 8 5s are 40 divided by 12 5s are 60. Next 9 5s are 45 divided by 12 5s are 60. Now denominators are common. Now I can write it. In between 2 by 3 and 3 by 4, I have 41 by 60, 42 by 60, 43 by 60, 44 by 60. These numbers are in between these two rational numbers. And that is not limited. If you are multiplying by 6 by 6, you will get 6 numbers. If you multiply by 100 by 100, you can get it 100 rational numbers. So, in between two rational numbers, unlimited rational numbers are available. We can choose it according to our requirement. Next one, compare, add or subtract. First one, compare. We are going to compare it. 5/6 and 7/6. Now, if the denominators are same, we don't have any problem. Directly we can compare it. Here 5/6, this is 7/6. Here, when the denominators are equal, we have to compare the numerator. Numerator 7 is the greatest one. So, we compare it easily. But, if the denominators are different, 5/6, this is 6/7. Denominators are different. So, first we have to convert this denominator into common denominator. So, 5/6 into 7/7. 5/7s are 35. 6/7s are 42. Next, the 6/7 into 6/6 is equal to 6/6 are 36 divided by 6/7s are 42. Now we can compare it. 35 divided by 42, 36 divided by 42. Here 36 is the greatest number because denominators are equal, so we are comparing numerator. Numerator 36 is the greatest value, so less than 35 by 42 less than 36 by 42. So this is the way to compare two fractions. Next one, add. Here add and subtract, same method. If the denominators are same, I am going to use the same example. Same example. 5/6, 7/6. If denominators are common, we can add it directly. Common denominator 6. 5 plus 7 is equal to 12 divided by 6. 12 divided by 6. We can write it. If it is different denominators, 5/6 plus 6/7. In this sum, denominators are different. So, first we have to convert the denominator into equivalent, that equal denominator. So, 5/6 into 7/7 equal to 35 divided by 42. Next, 6/7 into 6/6 is equal to 36 divided by 42. Now, denominators are same. Now, we can add it. Is equal to, now common denominator 42. 36 plus, sorry, 35 plus 36 is equal to common denominator 42. When we are adding 5 plus 6 is equal to 11. Remaining 1, 3 plus 3, 6. 6 plus 1, 7. So, 71 by 42 is answer. So, if the denominators are the same, we can just add it, we can write it. If the denominators are different, we have to convert it into equal denominator, then we have to add. Next, the same concept. Now, we are going to see the subtraction. In subtraction also same concept. 2/3 minus 4/3. Here, the denominators are same. So, directly we are going to write common denominator. 2 minus 4 is equal to, when signs are different, we have to find the difference. Difference is 2 and here greatest number is 4. In front of greatest number, minus sign is there. So, minus 2/3. Now, if the denominators are different, 2/3 minus 3/4. Here, denominators are different. So, first we have to convert the denominator into common denominator. So, 2/3 into 4/4 is equal to 2 fours are 8 divided by 3 fours are 12. And next, 3/4 into 3/3 is equal to 3 threes are 9 divided by 4 threes are 12. Now I have common denominator. Now I am going to subtract. This 2/3 minus 3/4 can be written 8/12 minus 9/12 is equal to common denominator 12. So, 12, 8 minus 9 is equal to 8 minus 9. Here signs are different, so difference is 1 and the greatest number 9, in front of greatest number minus sign is there. So minus 1 divided by 12. Next, we are going to see that multiplication and division. Multiplication and division. First we are going to see multiplication. We can take it number 7 by 8. Into minus 4 by 3. In multiplication, no problem, just we have to multiply numerator into numerator, denominator into denominator. 7 4s are 28 plus into minus is equal to minus divided by 8 3s are 24. That's all. If it is division, there is a small important point is that here when we are writing 12 divided by 16, divide 16 divided by 18 is equal to, first we have to write it the number, first number 12 by 16, this division is converted into multiplication, then this number 16 by 18 will be taken as a reciprocal, 18 by 16. Here we are converting this decimal, we are converting this division into multiplication, then this 16 by 18 is converted as a reciprocal, 18 by 16. If it is possible, we can simplify. We are simplifying by 2. 6 2s are 12, 8 2s are 16, here 9 2s are 18, 8 2s are 16. Again there is a possibilities, 3 2s are 6, 4 2s are 8, and here we cannot simplify hereafter, so we have to write it 3 by 4 into 9 by 8 is equal to, now if it is possible we can simplify, otherwise we have to multiply, 3 9s are 27 divided by 8 4s are 32, so when we are dividing 12 by 16, divide 16 by 18 is equal to 27 divided by 32. Okay, that's all students. Kindly give your suggestions in the comments box. Share this video to your friends and subscribe our channel. Thank you.